So welcome to this installment of BWB TV. I'm Brian Guzzi, I'm an associate editor with the Bioprocess International magazine. And as the conference is unfolding, I'm really excited to be speaking with Patti Seymour, who is a managing director at BDO Industry Specialty Services. So I guess we'll just jump right in then, yeah? So tell me about how you help clients in your work at BDO.
Yeah, well, thanks, Brian. I'm really thrilled to be able to speak with you about this as well. So at BDO, we help our clients in many different ways, but we many of the products that we work on with our clients are going through a journey. So we actually help them navigate the product from the start to the end. And part of that is really defining, like, where do they want to go with this product? And if you don't actually have an end point in mind, you're going to end up in a lot of different places, and it could be a smooth journey or a very rough journey if you don't plan that out early on. And that's how we help a lot of our clients doing that. One of the tools that we have specifically that I think differentiates us from some of the other types of consulting companies that work in this space is a product that we call BioTRAK. And that actually helps the industry understand where the supply and demand balances are in accessing biomanufacturing capacity.
So can you tell me a bit more about BioTRAK?
Sure. So we've been working on developing BioTRAK for the last 10 years, and it's an asset that is a database that we build up the types of capacity that are available throughout the biomanufacturing space. So if you're looking to manufacture proteins and other types of recombinant molecules, we'll know what kind of capacity is out there, whether you're looking at 100 liters or 10,000 liters. We balance that out by looking at the types of products that actually need that type of capacity. And so we're able to do some forecasting about what type of capacity is available, where is it available, who's doing what in that type of manufacturing.
I understand that you're also working with clients in the gene therapy space, and you've been doing it for some time. Could we see the pharmaceutical industry deliver on the promises of gene therapy in the next few years?
Well, certainly we hope so. It's an area that's growing rapidly. We've seen investment in that space grow from a few billion dollars to double-digit billions of dollars over the last 5 years. Certainly the promise of that technology is still waiting to be seen. There are a few commercial products out there, but dozens, if not hundreds of products in development in this space. One of the challenges, however, is actually getting access to capacity for manufacturing. So the BioTRAK that I talked about, we focus mostly on recombinant proteins. However, we are building that out to look at the types of manufacturing needed for gene therapy. And that's one of the big areas that we help our clients as well, is trying to figure out how to manufacture these types of products so that they're not as amenable to platform manufacturing as typical proteins are. So each type of manufacturing could be a little bit different.
So how do you help clients to determine whether to build or to buy?
Yeah, it's an excellent question, because one of the things that we saw 20 years ago in the protein space is that there wasn't enough capacity. And so they actually did build their own facilities. To some degree right now, we are seeing that decision happening, where companies do not find that they are able to access the capacity outside, so they're considering building. So we'll go and work with them to do an analysis. Do they have a particular technology that's proprietary, that there's no other place capable of manufacturing it? Then that might make sense to bring it in-house. However, if you only have one or two product assets that you're developing, and you invest all of your resources in brick and mortar in a facility, and the product unfortunately does not is not successful in clinical trials, then you've put all those resources into that facility and not into the clinical development. So it's a very delicate balance to help the clients determine what is the best approach for their particular modality.
Are there enough CMO partners to work with companies right now?
Well, it does depend on the modality. So certainly if it's a protein, there's enough companies out there, whether they have the right type of capacity is one thing. In the cell and gene therapy, that's definitely an area that needs more capacity in terms of getting access to the manufacturing. So I think that's a great growth opportunity right now, whether it's a CMO looking to expand into that area, other types of investors looking to get into that area. That's one of the things that we're able to do with BioTRAK, again, is we work with both CMOs and investor type companies to say what's out there, what's available, what's the need, and help them actually forecast how to invest, how to grow, and where what types of capacity to grow in. So it's a great tool that has a lot of value for lots of different types of end users.
Excellent. Yeah. So thank you for your time, and thank you for watching BWB TV. Stay tuned for our next episode. Thank you.